Has to do with trumpet. Yes, I know what trumpet is. Let's go to Leviticus 23.
Yeah.
Leviticus 23. Just one, two verses. Two verses there. Two verses there. The have and the have nots. And believe it or not, and this is a feast message. Amen. I'm like Aladdin. I don't like quiet people. This is a feast message.
Amen.
It's a feast message. Amen. The have and the have not. Evangelist, verses 23 and 24. We thank God we have Elder Newton Clark with us from the island of Jamaica. Yes. He'll be going home soon. Amen. I don't know how soon. Amen. Friday? Well, he's going home very soon then. Amen. We thank God for Bishop Lopez. Dr. Keisha, Gabriel, I want you to stand here, baby doll, too. Because I love you. And the Lord spoke to Moses. Is that a King James Version? God don't spoke, God spake. Amen. Amen. You made me do a Bishop Woods moment there. I didn't have to look at my Bible to see that was not. Amen. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak, hear this real good. Speak unto the children of Israel, saying, in the seventh month, in the first day, shall ye, everybody say have. Everybody say have. Shall ye have, shall you have a Sabbath, a memorial of the blowing of trumpets, and a holy convocation. Shall ye what?
Have.
The have and the have nots.
Yes.
Usually when these days come, we speak of all of its origin and all of its rituals. But we tend to forget. He said these are the feasts of the Lord. Hear me good. The Bible says the earth is the Lord. See, when we talk about the physical things, that's the Lord. We get excited when we gain possession. Y'all be with me or what? We get excited when we think about the physical, material things that belong to the Lord. And when he allow us to have them, we get excited. We just dance for, praise God, for property. Oh, come on, y'all gonna stay with me now? Y'all stay with me? We just rejoice for property because the Lord has blessed and allowed house of God here for Pentecost to what? To have. Oh, y'all with me now? He allowed them to have.
Bless the Lord.
Are y'all with me? These are the feasts of the Lord, but he have ownership of it. But one day he decided to let us y'all really understood where I was coming from. That would already be excited. I could sit down. He let us have this thing. See, well, he said, well, in this particular month, I could have done it any month.
Right.
I want you to understand it now. See, people trying to make significant, well, it's the seventh month, this, that, and the other. God could have said this in the fourth month, but he decided to say it in the seventh month because we have a Sabbath every week.
Right.
So it was not that we needed another Sabbath, but it was something that's special about this Sabbath.
Right.
See, we can understand when God gives us something, he's basically telling us we can have it.
Right.
Now, I'm going to play with words because we get so ritualistic sometimes we miss something. You know, sometimes when you give somebody something, and I'm almost finished.
Go ahead.
And when you give it to them, and they're going to give it back, first thing you say, you can do what?
Have it.
No.
If,
say thank you. You can do what?
Keep it.
All right, now you're staying with me. Y'all going to stay with me now?
Yeah.
I guarantee I'm tired in the morning. Anybody else in here? I have not been asleep since yesterday. All right?
Bless you,
I'm going to tell the truth with my wife. I'm going to tell the truth to somebody?
Yeah.
Amen. I haven't been to sleep yet. Wait, did y'all stay with me?
Yes.
If you give something to someone and they go to give it back, you tell them do what?
Keep it.
Well, God gave us a Sabbath.
Right.
And what did he tell us to do with it, church? And too many times our actions cause us to give it back.
Right.
Y'all ain't with me. Yes. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And when you choose not to observe it, basically you're saying is that I'm giving it back.
Mercy.
But I'm so glad that one day God said the Sabbath was made for man. See, God thought so much of you that before you ever got a house.
Thank you, Lord.
Before you ever had any natural possession, he gave you a Sabbath. Come on, somebody. When we hear Sabbath, we think of most ritualistic things. But we don't think of that Sabbath in God means reprieve, an intermission. So Jesus didn't change the concept of it when he gave the great invitation. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. And he basically was saying, and I will give you a Sabbath. What he was saying is, I will give you a rest. Now that's why I can say I have it. Others say they observe it. Notice the difference? A lot of people say they observe it. It's time for us to say we have it. Oh, come on. I hope that's what I'm saying. If God said you shall have it, then that means we possess it. So, yes, I'm a Sabbath keeper. Not as far as observing it, because it's mine. Now let me close. Why did he start with the Sabbath to let us have it? Because in the end, when the things are coming to an end, there's something else that he is going to allow us to have. That's why Elder spoke about the day of Pentecost. See, you have to understand what belongs to God when he gives it to us. How are we supposed to react? We are supposed to get excited for everything he gives us. When somebody gives you something, you want to say, thank you. So when you look on the calendar and these feast days are coming up, and you get upset because now I got to go tell my boss I can't work and he might make me lose my job, you ought to say, thank God. Because he let me have it. See, I got a message for the bus. I'll get back on the bus. I'm saying, remember, you asked me a question, did you, Bishop? I said, you asked me a question. He said, what's the purpose for going up there? Now he done made a fool of it. He done messed with Bishop now. You, I got a message to get back on the bus. And I said, well, I said, in your mind, you said that it is the Jewish holiday. But I said, for us, we have Holy Day. This is not the Jews' day. These are the feasts of the Lord. These are my feasts. When I'm so bad, somebody, he let me have it. Oh, somebody, he let me have it. Everybody don't have it. But I'm so bad, I'm part of the have and not part of the have not. And I began with the cross. I received the gift of the Holy Ghost. And today I'm part of the have. The have not, the spirit of Christ, the love of him, the have and the have not. I may not have money, as long as I have Jesus, I got all I need. Say yeah. Say yeah. Are you glad you have it? Let me share so much of my possession. This was in your portfolio that God gave you. The Bible telling me, let me check my portfolio. Let me stop here and say, for God so loved the world. He gave. That's what it is. He gave. And when he gives it, somebody has to do what? Receive it. And if the church is going to say, have you got it? Got it, like the Bible said, say yeah. He said, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but shall. Can you see it? I heard him say in the story of the prodigal son. He said, all I have is yours. He's our father. All we have is ours. And because we can have it, all he says, ask, shall be given. Seek, he shall find. Just gotta receive it. You can't work it up. You just gotta receive it. Because all it is a gift. You got to receive it. And I'm so glad we didn't deserve it. But he let us have it. Can you say amen? Because while we were yet sinners, that's when he died. He gave it to us. We were at our worst. Every now and then, when I go in Williamsburg, and I know some of them are from business with them, and I tease them. I said, you think these things belong to you, but these things belong to me. But he said, ye shall have a Sabbath. He gave us a Sabbath as a sign. So church, I found out I got in trouble yesterday. Am I my daughter? I got in trouble yesterday. I was in a Sabbath keeping church. I was preaching the word of God. And by chance, I was thanking God for the incoming of the Feast of Trumpets. I was not in the right place, I was in the right place. See, we ought to say this to God. I didn't go to preach that day. I knew it had to be real. I had no clue that they said they are Sabbath keepers. I had no clue they did not keep the feast day. And God said he would not have us in part. We got to stop apologizing for preaching the truth. But he said, go ye therefore, teach all nations. I didn't tell us to skip over this one. He said, cry loud. They want to send the fornicator. They want to kill the adulterer. Don't get the people who have. Just keep one Sabbath. Because God did not go to Luke to that Leviticus 23 and put one Sabbath in there. He gave us Sabbath. Young people. Young people. excited for these days because it allows you to have schools off. But until you get the spiritual realm, at least thank God, because in these days you have school. I'm keeping it real. And there's nothing wrong with being excited. You know what I praise God for? Because I have it. Y'all might think this is crazy. Because he allowed me to have this Sabbath, I wouldn't have to move my car for 4 days. See, we live in Manhattan, we know what that's all about, right? See, you have to just pull up and get a space. We have to drive around for hours to find a space. Because he said, you shall have a Sabbath. And it doesn't fall on the seventh day. On tomorrow, during the day, I don't have to worry about no ticket person. Because he gave me a Sabbath. Trumpets. But that's not what the Bible said. The Bible said it shall be. You shall have a Sabbath. A memorial. A memorial. Trumpets. What is it? Every year when we take possession of the Sabbath, we are rehearsing. What are we rehearsing for? We are rehearsing for when the Lord himself shall proceed from the heaven with the trump of God, with the voice of an archangel. When he blows the trump, somebody wrote a song. Say, where shall I be? Then the first trumpet shadow. They said, my God, call me by the thunder, the trumpet sound in my soul. I haven't got long to stay here. I'm so glad he gave us the Holy Ghost so we can have a connection through the sound of the trumpet. Say yeah. That's why he said he didn't have power. He didn't hear the Spirit. He said to the church, and I'm so glad that the Spirit that raised Christ from the dead has got a breakdown. I'm so glad that I heard very little tonight about the ritual. When we get carried away with the rituals until we forget about Jesus. Can you see this? Because whether you know it or not, these days are not about rituals. These days are about the mighty works of God. Everything that we do was to testify of God. These days are supposed to be about Jesus. No, I heard him say. Now we said that this is the scriptures, right? Well, I heard him say, Jesus said, correct me if I'm wrong, but Jesus said, search the scriptures, for you know, you think you have eternal life, but then you what? They testify of me. When you blow the trumpet, you testify of Jesus. When you rest on the seventh day, you testify of Jesus. But if you get, you have it. So as I stop, I couldn't close, but let me stop. As I stop, I don't worry with people that don't want to accept it. Because what is some don't believe, I'm not here trying to convince anybody. I just got enough time to save myself. But today, when you hear God's voice, harden not your heart. if anybody would get upset, because the pastor said you need the Holy Ghost with evidence, speaking in tongues, the dead can't please him, but the spirit that was in that person before he died, that was spirit that the Holy Ghost is going to be in when that trumpet sound. So why would you take a chance? So today when you hear God's voice, harden not your heart, let the wicked forsake his ways, for all the righteous is God. And they have not. They have. And they have not. I'm not in competition with anyone with degrees, with money, with possession. I got Jesus. Educated. Take it away from me. Anybody possess Jesus? Anybody possess Jesus? You need to turn around. Stop just saying, I serve Jesus. Stop just turning around, I believe in Jesus. We gotta kill all these cliches. These cliches sound good, but you gotta realize what they're not saying. Amen. Even the Muslims acknowledge Jesus. Oh, come on, come on. Wake up here. Even the Muslims acknowledge Jesus. Even the 12-step program acknowledge a higher power. But you got to be more than that. Don't just say, I recognize Jesus. I honor Jesus. Man. Say, I got Jesus. I got Jesus. I got to be here. We said, I got a cold. We don't mind telling her, I got a cold. We don't mind coming to church and testify, I got cancer. I'm trying to get out the way here. We don't mind saying, I got heart trouble. Lord, let me stop. We don't mind saying, I got trouble in the hole. When was the last time you saw the devil? That God didn't give you, that came from the devil, God didn't give it to you. Stand up and tell the devil, when God gave you. The brothers used to say, they said, destroy, but I feel. I experience. See, that's the sign of a not for sure person. But the mother. They want to make sure that they will slow down. They said, this God.
not enough for the other stuff. And that's what we preachers talking about. See, God, y'all stand up for praises and so forth. We don't know how to sit down on the word. And all that mess is probably exercise. I just give you a word. Now, if you check your portfolio, and if you have it, I want you to stand up with me. And I'm going to say, well, yes, I got it.